Wendy and Starlight weren't being very nice to Kyle either tonight. What were they doing?
What
did they say?
Okay, give me a timestamp, if that's true.
Okay, let's wait.
Okay, so can we talk a little bit about wide brim hats, or no?
About what?
Wide brim hat, or no?
Oh my god!
Is that a thing
sure.
to talk about or no?
Yeah. No, we may make some people mad, but okay, like, I'm not for it.
I just have some questions, but I don't, you know, I don't get it. But
I don't get it.
I'm not trying to bash anyone who does get it, but
I just
why don't we say any words when we're?
But he did today. He did today.
Uh huh.
Did you see that?
I did. Yeah.
Yeah.
Where was that? Oh, that was on Molly.
Did she just say she doesn't understand why he doesn't say any words?
Yeah, she did.
Isn't she a special ed teacher?
Yeah.
Doesn't she work with hearing impaired students? Wow, you're a dumb a-hole, Wendy. You really are.
I don't know.
If I had a hearing impaired child, you would be the last person I would want to work with my child. I'm just saying.
Well, don't. I don't want to get anybody in trouble. I just don't understand. I don't understand the hat thing, and I don't understand the no talking thing.
Yeah, me either.
And it's a little, it kind of creeps me out, which is fine. Yeah.
Why does it creep you out?
Wendy, you're a piece of trash. Garbage.
You can be part of it. It's not a problem. I'm not hating anybody who wants to be part of it. I just have a question.
So now Kyle's a creep. Here's the intelligent, mature thing to do, Wendy. Why don't you invite him on your panel and ask him questions? Because he'll answer them in his own way.
Can you give Starlight a link?
I don't know if it's like a fetish. I asked if it was.
I don't know the answer to that. I don't need to know the answer to that.
That's the only conclusion I can come to. And because I don't know, like people say that person is not on the same mentality level, I guess, of other people.
Good night, Grammar Judge.
I personally think he is.
Me too.
And I feel like we're being played a little bit. And I don't know how to like say that without hurting or people thinking that I'm making fun of him, because I'm not. But right. I think if he gets this quote unquote pass, I don't even know what a pass would be for.
I'm getting nervous.
I don't know what we're passing him on. Hey, Starlight.
Hi.
Okay. Hi. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
I don't know, Kyle. I've heard him talk. I heard him talk today. And y'all say he has a disability. How do I know he has a disability? I don't know.
He's social awkward.
How do you know that?
Because I'm social awkward. I have
you
that.
Talk, Ash.
I know. I understand that. But maybe he doesn't
want to. He talks.
Sometimes he does.
Okay, well, if he is or if he's not, I don't know.
But here's the thing. He communicates, though. That's the thing, is he communicates. Yes. He speaks, he nods, he uses his hands, he types in the chat. So he communicates.
Talk about wide-brimmed hats.
Right, exactly.
And it's starting to get a little weird, that's all. And
what's
I'm sorry.
About a hat?
That's mean. It's not the hat. It's
it
the constant
mean,
asking about it.
So he's perseverating on the wide-brimmed hat.
Why a man...
So does Wendy not understand why somebody would perseverate on a wide-brimmed hat? Is she really that stupid? Why he, is fixated and perseverates on wide-brimmed hats? Is that
I asked Kyle
Wendy
straight up if it was a fetish, and he told me yes.
He did? Where was that?
In a chat. I think he came in my chat, and I asked.
Yeah, we will keep listening.
I'd like to see him admit that it was a fetish.
And so I understand that he is with people who encourage that and like it, and they celebrate that with him. So I'm glad he has a little corner to go into. I just didn't know any of the real background. So when we have these little parties, what is he doing up there on the panel?
That's what I'm wondering. And then what?
Wendy, why don't you watch him if you're wondering what he's doing? He has his camera on. Does Kyle know what a fetish? Does he know what a fetish means?
Why do you think you automatically just assume that this guy has no clue what's going on or knows what the real world
is? I never said that.
Well, to be blunt, you're making him sound dumb, and he's not dumb.
How did I make him sound dumb?
By asking if he knows what a fetish is. He's a grown man.
Some people may not know what a fetish is. He may have just agreed to it. I don't know. So we're saying that he gets sexual gratification from the hats.
I don't know. We didn't clarify that part of it.
Yeah, that's why I'm wondering if he knows what he was being asked. That's all.
Okay. I bet he knows how to Google too.
Well, I mean, I don't know. I don't have questions. He seems pretty harmless. I mean, he doesn't get on panels and curse out people and, you know, trash and slander them. He's doing better than a lot of people in the community who get on panels.
But he is noticed now. Mm-hmm. Everyone notices it.
Wendy's people pretty critical of him, questions. Though, for not knowing
she
anything about
questions.
Him.
She had questions. She had questions. What's okay. wrong with
you
that?
You don't have to I'd like her to answer, though.
I think
don't have
it's
to answer
so,
for
I
her.
Think, I think
I'm just wonder why she's so critical of him and doesn't really know anything
because
about
him. Because we had questions, and I'm sorry from an outsider's point of view who doesn't know anything, it kind of comes off creepy to some people. I'm not saying it comes off creepy to everyone, but there are some people that don't understand it. That's all. There's not a lot of men in this community, so when, you know, things like that kind of come around, someone's going to raise their eyebrow and be like, what the hell? I wish Kyle would have been there, so maybe he could have answered, you know what I mean? But he wasn't there.
He could hear this. That's yeah. my thing.
So I just feel like a lot of people are starting to attack him, and there have been comments and chats by people. Before. Thank you, Liberty. The whole wide-brimmed hat thing started in MFW's one night when she had a wide-brimmed hat on. He started showing up in comment sections after that.
Okay, so he comes from basically MFW. I was just wondering what, like, corner of YouTube and how he found us type of thing. So I'm guessing it's probably from that.
Listen, if he creeps you out, then just block him, problem solved. And that's the thing is that...
No, we don't creep
Wendy,
out.
Well, Wendy said that, though. It creeps around, and she has quite a voice in the community, and everybody knows that. So I think that's really irresponsible and actually disgusting that for somebody who doesn't really know about what's going on to get up there and run her fat mouth.
But
that's just her opinion.
Of course Wendy doesn't know him.
Then
she
should shut her fat mouth.
Certain things. Well, it comes off a little creepy to people who don't understand the situation.
But
you are you're criticizing children. Wendy because you don't like her. That's it.
No.
No,
oh my
part
God.
Of my thing about Wendy is that she does work with special needs children, so she should have some kind of understanding.
She's gross.
Where she...
But he's not mute, and he's not incapable of talking. I think he purposely...
About his look. Did you guys talk about his look? Just asking.
It wasn't us. That
okay.
Other people have said that he has a certain look, and I said, well, Brian St. John is a certain look, too, so there's that. I'm just saying.
What does him have... Being
I don't know what the look would be.
Anything,
huh?
What does him being mute have to do with anything, though? Whether
I don't
he can
he's not mute. Not. He's not mute.
No, he's not, but he prefers to not talk. He's more comfortable.
I know, that's confusing.
Molly,
I'm sorry, I've never met anyone like that.
Okay, keep playing. They say, listen to the end. Okay.
We saw a little
does ask people to have these parties. He wants them to cam up and
how
do it.
Always
on the spectrum, though.
So what is that? What's he doing?
I just feel a certain type of way.
Mary, is he doing what I hope he's not ever doing?
What
is...
I hope not, is what I said.
Oh, my God.
I don't know. I'm starting to think there's really nothing even wrong with him. That's just me, and I guess...
Sorry, I'm back.
Hang me from the rafters. Now you want to pick
I'm
me apart?
I'm sorry, I'm back. I mean,
everything
you just said. Uh-oh, here comes Steph.
Okay, Hello? Good. No, I'm glad.
For what?
Do you want to pick me apart for what I just said?
What'd you say?
I said that I'm starting to think there's nothing even wrong with him.
Well, then why are you talking about him?
Because I have questions.
Because you think there's something wrong with his fixation on hats.
No, I don't know if he is... How do y'all know he's slow? Nobody knows what is wrong with him. Maybe he's just a regular guy who gets on panels and doesn't talk. That's what I think.
But what makes you think that? Because he can talk?
Because I've never... No, because when I hear him talk, he's normal. I think maybe he doesn't talk because his mom is usually in the other room. I think that may be part of why he doesn't talk. I can sit here and speculate all day.
But is he bothering you?
No, did I ever say that? He's not
no,
a problem.
No, I'm just asking.
People
I'm just wondering why
question.
He's being
I'm
discussed.
I'm not the only person, but I put myself up here. I didn't know that was going to come up.
But Starlight, don't you see how the discussion that you're having up there could just really negatively affect his, you know, reputation in this community? How about this? Why are we questioning somebody who's not hurting anybody? Like
because
on a panel, like making a big deal with 400
it's
or
not a big
people.
Deal. You want to know what's making
it
a
big deal? No, it
you
is a big
doing
deal.
This panel.
No. What's making it is a big deal that you guys were talking about him on panel like you were in front of almost 500 people, and he got brought into my chat asking me about it, so now I'm playing it, and I have a problem with things that were said about him.
Okay, well, you're entitled to be offended because you get offended
no,
over everything.
No, I'm not saying I'm offended, but I have a problem with
you. You cannot tell me that you know this and you know this as a fact when it comes to Kyle.
I don't know
don't.
Anything about I only know what
me
I observe
either.
From him. But,
yeah.
And what I'm saying is, why is he being questioned if he's not
because
hurting anyone?
Because it comes off to some people as a little creepy.
So they can block him if they don't care for him.
Okay, yeah, I guess so.
Maybe y'all could have just said that, like, okay, we get that Kyle kind of, you know, people don't understand him. They may be leery about him. Just go ahead and block him, and you'll be fine.
Okay, thank you, Master Fraud.
Wouldn't that just be more constructive? I mean, I'm just
thank you. Next time I talk about, I'll make sure to do that.
Look, where he came from, all I know is he used to be, he started in Makeup Mobsters months ago, and it was always about white-brimmed hats. And we kind of got annoyed and pushed him away until he came to FODS.
I don't remember that.
And when he camped up, in my opinion, I think he looks...
Yeah, but I think Brian St. John looks...
Oh, dear.
Well, I mean, if we're going to play that game...
I get it. Okay. He types in the private chat, and he doesn't talk on the panel that often. Like, sometimes he'll blurt something out. Like, the first time I put a hat on and cammed up, he was pissed because I was running late. That was the night he said rerun, because FODS was kind of stalling and telling a story that FODS had already told once.
Oh, that came from Kyle? I didn't even know the rewind. That's funny. See, that tells me he knows what he's doing.
Yeah, no, he's very in tune, like, he knows what's going on. But he speaks in outbursts, like, he won't come up and have a conversation.
Well, I think that's on purpose.
What I'm curious about is, are you thinking that he does things, like, inappropriate? While he's up here on panel looking at women in hats.
No, I don't
think. No, nuh-uh.
No.
Because you would hope.
Obvious. Because, I mean, I'm just saying, because if he is, I'm not trying to knock the guy's fetish, but I'm not willing to subject people in this community to that without telling them, at least.
No, he's not doing that. And he does, and he always does cam up.
Wendy, you're an idiot. Just wanted to interject that.
Oh, my God.
Like, he's behind an avatar, like, and you're wondering what he's doing. No, and he stands up and walks out of the room, and he comes back in.
I've wondered if the reason he doesn't really talk is because, I'm guessing he lives with his mother. And maybe he doesn't want her to hear him talking. Maybe.
Because when I did throw him his birthday party, he was there for a second.
Jeff.
He kept kind of yelling, I don't know. I don't want to, like, mimic how he talks, but he was saying, not right now, or stop. And then he left the room, and then there was a person that came in, and it looked like a mom or an older person. And all we saw was forehead and hair, and they were just staring at the computer screen for about 3 minutes, and then they left, and then Kyle came back. So he's definitely under the care of somebody. And so all is he this about his wide-brimmed hats.
Is this the guy that Molly got in trouble with when she was like, do you sign? Are you deaf? And she, like, pretended, like, to talk to a deaf person, which was highly offensive. Because it was very wrong.
It's gross.
It was gross, yeah. Highly offensive as a person who works with deaf people. Very offended. But whatever. So that's who that is. Okay, well, so no one's ever seen him do anything, like, R-rated?
No.
Okay.
Nope. Molly even offered to show him her tits, and he declined.
Well, I would, too. I get that.
He's not a pervert.
He's not asking for boobs or anything. He's not hitting
people. Hey, Bodie. Hey, Duran.
Put a wide brim hat on her.
I don't know. He's not asking for email addresses or phone numbers. He's not asking for anything but a wide brimmed hat. That's it.
Isn't there a hat community he could go to? They probably got more.
Isn't there a stupid idiot community you could go to, Wendy? Just wondering. Motley, why does he go on panels and not talk? He actually, well, he does talk sometimes, but he does communicate. So. He does it in his own way. So
how's that? Can you tell me what his way of communicating is? Because I guess I missed
that.
He types, and he uses his hands, and he uses his head. He uses many different ways to communicate, and he will speak when he feels like it, apparently.
Right.
But again, so he's communicating on a panel.
Why does that, though? Why do you take that as him having a disability?
Maybe I didn't say he had a disability. I'm just inferring that he is comfortable communicating other ways than using his voice.
Exactly, that's what I'm saying, but other people are saying he has a disability. So my question is this just a personal choice of his? And he's just, you know, like a regular person, like everybody else, whatever regular is.
Yeah.
And his choice is just not to speak. I can understand that.
Right. These people here are saying, oh, he's so creepy, and what, is he whacking off to the hats, blah, blah, blah. And everybody is saying all these disgusting things about him and to him, and he has to be subjected to that, and he's done nothing wrong.
But Bob's point is about the conversation at hand is that it was public and that now other people are going to feel more comfortable about talking about him.
Yeah.
They probably are, Emma. They probably are, and I think Wendy should apologize to him for starting that conversation about him. She absolutely does. It was irresponsible. She has a big platform. She has a big fat mouth to go along with it, and she owes him an apology for referring to him as a creep, suggesting he's whacking off to it, and he acts more respectable than you ever have on panel, Wendy, so, you know,